dead, wrap the mantle of the red, the black and the green around me. For in the new life I shall rise up with God's grace and blessing, to lead the millions of the heights and the triumph that you well know. Look for me in a world when there are storms. Look for me all around you. For with God's grace, I shall come back with countless millions of black men and women who have died in America, those who have died in the West Indies, and those who have died in Africa, to aid you in the fight for liberty, freedom, and life. Any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave you. Any leadership that teaches you to depend upon another race is a leadership that will enslave. They gave leadership to our foreparents and that leadership made them slaves. But we have decided to find a leadership of our own to make ourselves free men. Our great scholars, having passed through the colleges and universities, have thrown away the blessed record. Babylon did it. Assyria did it. France under Napoleon did it. Germany under Prince von Bismarck did it. England under America under George Washington did it. Africa with 400 million black people can do it. If you cannot do it, if you are not prepared to do it, then you will die. You race of cowards, you race of imbeciles, you race of good for nothings. If you cannot do what other men have done, what other nations have done, what other races have done, then you have better die. Can we do it? We can do it. We shall do it. We pray to God for vision and for leadership. And He has given us our universal vision. A vision that will not limit our possibilities to America. A vision that will not limit our possibilities to the West Indies. But a vision that said it must be a free and redeemed Africa. Christ the crucified, Christ the despised. We appeal to you for help, for succor, for leadership. When you endeavor to carry your burden up the heights of Calvary, when white men scorned you, when white men scorned you, when white men spat upon you, when white men pierced your side out of which blood and water gushed forth, it was a black man in the name of Simon the Syrian who took and brought the burden up the heights of Calvary. And now that we are bearing our burden of being so heavy, we just ask that you just help us on up the heights. Oh yes, the cause is grand, the cause is glorious. Surely we shall not turn back. Oh, sail on, sail on, sail on, oh mighty shepherd state, sail on. Sail on until the flag of the red, the black and the green is perched upon the hills of their Africa. Because the time has come for the black man to forget his hero worship of other races and to create and emulate heroes of his own. We must canonize our own saints, create our own martyrs, and elevate the positions of fame and honor black men and women who have made a distinct contribution to our racial history.